after the another Mankar was captured, the my company's success signal was ye dil mange more. The guys were so highly charged up that they're wanting that some more Mankars should have been there and we would have got the more chaps.
As we celebrate this very special day of triumph and victory, students of our Bolton School had the opportunity to interview the real-time heroes of our country. Let's give our ears to this very enriching interaction on the saga of commitment for the well-being of our nation. Wing Commander Azizunnisa Tayyaba has served with the Indian Air Force for 15 long years as Wing Commander in the Administrative Branch HR. Holds merit of being from the first batch of women officers to join Indian Air Force way back in 1992. During her tenure with Indian Air Force, she has served the nation in most prestigious bases with prestigious appointments and is proud to be associated with Kargil War. She is currently working with Shaporji Pallonji and Company Private Limited, heading the regional HR in Hyderabad. She is responsible for the entire HR operations in the region as general manager. Corporate social responsibility is her forte and is passionate about it. She is a postgraduate in geography with a gold medal from Usmania University. She has a PG diploma in human resource management and is a proud alumni of Indian Institute of Management Ahmedabad in business management. She loves adventure sports, traveling and painting. She has done para jumping and holds a record in the Limca Book of World Records for being the second lady paratrooper in India after 45 years gap. She is a trained parasailing instructor in adventure sports. She has done microlight flying, river rafting, skywalking and hand gliding. She is unmarried and a single parent to an adopted daughter, Miss Tabassum. Ms. Tabassum is currently working with Apollo Hospital as counseling psychologist.
Good morning, madam. I'm Mahati Krishnan from grade 3. I studied Bolton School, Secunderabad. Thank you so much, ma'am, for giving me an opportunity to speak to you. My question to you is, what according to you is the true meaning of patriotism? How do we instill this feeling in the youth? How do you think schools can encourage girls to take up Air Force as a career choice?
What we see as parents, teachers and everyone around us talks about various careers like doctor, engineer, MBA professionals, lawyers or chartered accountant for that matter. No one even discusses about armed forces as a career. This may be due to lack of awareness and needs to be addressed at every platform. I think institutes can bridge this gap by adopting measures like, firstly, having certificate courses on military service in college and school. We have certificate courses on IT related subjects, animation, psychology, finance, then why not military service? Secondly, military history can be taught in schools and colleges and made a part of the curriculum. Few chapters about Indian Armed Forces can be included. Thirdly, have non-detailed storybook as a part of curriculum on the stories from Paramveer Chakra or military operations. Invite guest speakers from Armed Forces to share their experience and motivate the students. Schools should also have tie-up with Army, Navy and Air Force in the vicinity to take the senior students to these bases and give them familiarization with the armed forces. Lastly, make NCC as a compulsory training. How many Sainik schools do we have? merely 33 in this huge country. We need to establish more Senex schools so that youth are given an opportunity to understand what is military all about. And they get motivated to join the armed forces.
Good morning, ma'am. I'm Pratyush Kumar of grade 9. I study at Bolton School, Secunderabad. Thank you so much for giving me the opportunity to speak to you. My first question to you is, joining the aviation wing of the army itself is a big achievement. Being the first woman to do so must be quite a taxing thing. How did you cope with the stringent training? Did you face any other hurdles in the Air Force as you were the first woman officer, so to say?
Well, by joining in the Indian Air Force way back in 1992 and to be from the first batch of women officers was actually a dream come true. I was keen to create history since my childhood. I always associated myself to the tagline, "It's different. It's different, but how do I make myself different?" I used to think about being an engine driver in the Indian Railway and become the first girl to do so. I wanted to etch my name in the annals of history. However, I did not know how to do it. But the desire of becoming different and the first one did not die down. Time passed. I graduated and wanted to join the uniform service. And at that time, IPS was the only option. I was underage for the IPS. So I decided to pursue my post-graduation. While undergoing post-graduation, I came across a newspaper advertisement wherein Indian Air Force had opened its doors for women entry. I was overjoyed and jumped at the opportunity. My focus now shifted from Indian Railways to Indian Air Force. Those days, we did not have telephone, internet, or any media which could give us inputs on how to prepare for going for service selection. I consulted books, I connected with friends, and finally went for service selection board. I got selected amidst tough competition. In June 1992, I joined Air Force Academy as a trainee. During the training, we were informed that there were 25,000 applicants and only 12 vacancies. In 1993, we were commissioned into the Indian Air Force as pilot officers. It was a proud moment to be a part of this elite force. We had created history and my dream came true.
I'm Harshita from grade 10A and I study at Bolton School, Secunderabad. Thank you so much for giving me this opportunity to speak to you. Can you share with us a few experiences of your wartime adventure?
Real challenges began once I reported to my first airbase. There were nearly 2,000 men in blue and one me. Being from the first batch of women officers, there were a lot of publicity in media about us and all eyes and ears were on us. This had put additional responsibility and pressure to perform beyond expectation. We were new to the setup and our seniors, peers and subordinates were dealing with women in blue for the first time. Other than medical officers. There were instances when we were overprotected. Certain duties were not allowed to be performed. Soon I started feeling choked. I spoke to my boss. He said, "Aziz, you are young, energetic and enthusiastic. I'm worried that if something happens to you, how will I respond to the higher-ups?" I was not convinced. I spoke to my super boss, Air Officer Commanding, and explained to him, "Sir, I have joined Air Force to serve the nation along with my male counterpart and I am not here to expect any exemptions. When I am wearing the same uniform, drawing the same salary and I was trained along with the men folk, why this consideration and bias?" AOC was surprised that I was not being given adequate responsibility. Rather, I was given a special consideration for my gender. He promptly intervened and told the boss, "Air Headquarters has posted an officer to this base. Please treat her like an officer. Entrust her with her activities like other male officers." I felt relieved and I thanked the AOC and came out. Very next day, I was put on the duty officer's duty. I followed all other duties and role. including the guard checks, the patrolling, and the security officers' duty as well. It gave a message to the rank and file that we were here in the combat role and not merely a showcase. One more story of breaking barriers I must share with you all, and I call it as Mathura Ka Churan. Air Force gives opportunities to take up adventure activities and to volunteer. I was keen on doing parajumping and paratrooping. Whenever there was a mail communication seeking volunteers, I was not considered, merely because it was presumed it was meant only for men and not for women officers. I went and met a senior officer of paratrooping school and expressed my interest and the desire to jump off the aircraft. He said, "Aziz, parajumping koi Mathura ka churan thodi hai ki khaye aur kood gaye. You need lot of stamina, you need physical and mental strength. Aur kahin haath ya pair toot gaya to shaadi kaun karega?" In fact, this made my resolve even stronger. I decided and I went and met the director of Adventure Cell. He was very positive. In fact, he said, "Why not?" He realized that women are here and they can be a part of adventure team as well. So subsequent communication was sent specifically mentioning women officers also to apply. And I volunteered. I went for rigorous training at paratrooper school along with my men folk. There were 5 jumps. The 5th and the last jump is done in the dark and in the night. When you jump off the aircraft, you do not realize where you are going and you can only feel the breeze around you and what is the depth and how soon you are going to land. And this jump is from the aircraft from 1250 feet above the ground. As I landed, I could hear a lot of claps and accolades from my team members who were standing there to encourage me, and I inquired, "What is this all for?" They told me that I had created history. I said, "What?" They said, "I was the second lady paratrooper after a gap of 45 years to jump off the aircraft, and I had etched my name in the Limca Book of Records." I was feeling very happy. The senior officer who had said paratrooping is not Mathura Ka Churan also came and congratulated me, and he realized and he said, "Aziz, neither the aircraft nor the parachute nor the air or the Mother Earth knows whether it's a male or a female. It only realizes that it is a mass which is coming down on the earth, and we feel proud about you." In the span of 15 years with the Indian Air Force, there are numerous occasions and incidences where we had to constantly strive and prove ourselves. In fact, I can write a book on this. I was also a part of Kargil War. Indian Air Force was acting jointly with Indian Army, flushing out Pakistani troops. Being from the administrative branch, which is a strong support service, I was actively involved in movement and logistical support of the troops. And when men are away, their families are to be looked after by the unit administration, so that our fighting forces are not worried and they are dedicated for the operations. Our sacrifice, hardship and dedication of the first batch of women officers paved way for women in the fighter flying and other streams. We take pride in being a part of Indian Air Force for nearly 3 decades now. Jai Hind.
Thank you so much, ma'am, for taking our time to answer our questions and share with us your insightful experiences. This is definitely helpful and inspirational to all of us. I'm sure this message of yours will go strong on many in arousing the desire to dare the feat of aviation ways of safeguarding our nation. Jai Hind!